Chemicals, baby, I'm so hard to handle now, yes I am. Chemicals, baby, I'm so hot to hell now, yes I am. Thank you.
I'ma need to leave. I don't want nobody thinking that I'm impolite, but you best to step back when the bets at the mic. Now when you see me at a live show handling biz, I might make it look easy, that don't mean that it is. An old school survivor who can rhyme and produce, and a super technician with design on my loops. And this time I had the big drum kicks coming from the mix, pumped them up a bit till they hit like a ton of bricks. Sounds funky when I'm rapping along, I'm so matter of fact with the classic song. And that's the craft master, laugh and whack rappers. Yo, why's your flow so whack and haphazard? You can whine, bellyache, and complain about Lil Wayne in the state of the game, but please give me some room to breathe, breathe, breathe. I need a little bit of room to breathe, man. Check it out. Now when I fall into a rhythm, it's as good as it gets, and that's why I'm always rocking international sets. Staying cool and unfazed, stepping on any stage. Harajuku, Piccadilly, to the Champs-Élysées. I'm big, quick, and slippery. Spit slick is Ricky D. If you wanna get with me, it's another victory. My competition call it mission control, cause they know they've been exposed like fish in a bowl. So talk your ish, pop your lips and whisper, but I'm not gonna take it like Twisted Sister. Those folks who try to comply get a swollen eye, cause I'm kicking like a Cobra Kai. See, if we're gonna crash, I'll be the black box. You'd have a better chance winning lottery jackpots, because I got flavor that's good to the last drops, and more material than tall and fat chops. Please, give me some room to breathe. I'm gonna need a little bit of room to breathe. On the cut, give me room to breathe. Switch it up right now. Tell you a little story about this guy.
Go ahead.
There was this cat named Jack, always yapping, blasting on 10. And behind his back, his friends were laughing at him. Up until he would come around, then they have to pretend. But as soon as he walked away, they were cracking again. And not really hating to see him being mocked and despised. So I thought that I would try, pull him off to the side. And I got real serious, locking the eyes, and said, Jack, here's why you've been ostracized. But before I could finish, my man just jumped in, straight interrupting, not hearing nothing. Here's why you're suffering, too much talk. He then nodded his head and started sharing a thought. I said, dude, pay attention, stop waiting to speak before I grab you by your cheek and tape up your beak. You don't always have to pontificate and go deep. Just keep your mouth shut, cultivate a mystique. But when Jack cut me off again, I just lost it, mentally exhausted. I felt so accosted, and even worse, he was in my personal space, cause he cannot understand the disturbance he makes when he's saying,
give me your number, I'ma shoot you a text. I can swing by the crib, man, what's your address?
You know, I just sighed, told him goodbye, and when he launched into